Just like we visualize ray paths with curved mirrors in earlier video, we will explore ray paths for lenses, especially a convex lens. Instead of a regular biconvex lens made from glass, we will use a biconvex profile made from acrylic. Different profiles of lenses made with acrylic enable us to study ray path better. More on that later. Let's cover the basics first. When incident ray falls on the rectangular acrylic strip at 90 degrees, refracted ray extends the same path. Tilting the strip on either side changes the path of light ray leaving the strip. This is due to a phenomena called refraction we are all aware of. Light doesn't always change path when refraction occurs. Light changes path only when both mediums have different refractive index and light ray encounters a medium change at an angle other than normal. Let us replace this strip with a triangle made from acrylic. This is two-dimensional version of a regular prism we are familiar with. In this case, refracted light moves towards the wider side of a triangle. This is true even if we position it upside down. We can use two incident rays instead of one and understand the behavior of refracted rays better. This formation of triangles is similar to the convex lens profile. In fact, biconvex lens is a collection of many small prisms like this packed closely in a single piece. Let us use graph paper for this activity. To avoid keeping the switch of laser light pressed for long duration, I have used a plastic bottle. Eraser acts as a stand for the laser. Laser remains on as long as it is pressed inside the bottle. We'll place this graph paper on plastic containers. To make calculations easier, dashed lines are marked at a distance of 5 cm. Lasers placed on the left side act as a light source. Lenses are placed here so that we can calculate distances very easily. Rays coming from a laser onto a convex lens are called incident rays. These are refracted rays. This is principal axis. Placing a convex lens converges incoming parallel rays at a distance of 5 cm. This is also called focal length of the lens. Focal length will change with change in medium as well, like water instead of air. When an incident ray hits the lens, some of it is refracted while some of it is reflected back. Angle by which this happens is governed by the law of reflection. Let us look at three rules associated with refraction. We will use pieces of this matchstick for our analysis. Let us place convex lens here. center of the lens is marked as C. Points F marked in yellow are the focal points on each side, while points marked 2F in red color are at twice a distance of focal length from the center of the lens. As per this Simbhaket simulation, if an object is placed at twice the focal length from the lens, we get a real inverted image exactly at the same distance on the other side of the lens. We will call one mastic as an object and other one as an image. We can visualize three rules of refraction for a biconvex lens. As per the first rule, any incident ray traveling parallel to the principal axis of converging lens will refract through the lens and travel through the focal point on the opposite side of the lens. As per second rule, incident ray that passes through the center of the lens will continue its path. As per the third rule, any incident ray traveling through the focal point on the way to the lens will refract through the lens and travel parallel to the principal axis. Focal length of the lens depends on the other medium as well. Small plastic container is made by folding a transparent plastic sheet. Soap solution is added to view the ray paths inside water. Let us place this lens in water. When placed inside water, focal length of this convex lens is more in water than in air. Let us look at variations in type and size of the lens. Observe how the path of refracted ray changes as I move the lens perpendicular to the incident rays. Focal length changes as lenses of different radius of curvature are placed. This convex lens is of the same radius of curvature than the previous one, but it is thicker. Focal length doesn't change significantly when thickness of the lens varies for the same radius of curvature. These lenses have the same focal length but different thickness. Ideally, this thickness is very small as compared to the radius of curvature, but for our visualization purpose, it should work. This convex lens has different radius of curvature, 20 cm on one side and 30 cm on other side. This is a concave lens. Rays diverge after refraction, that is, rays move away from principal axis. This is plano convex lens. Acrylic lens in these forms are a good way to visualize the ray paths in lenses. And this is plano concave lens. We can place another convex lens next to this one and observe the combined effect. Effective focal length in this case is lower than the individual focal length of each lens. Focal length of plano convex lens is more than that of convex lens for the same radius of curvature. Two plano convex lens can be placed next to each other to get the result similar to a single convex lens. You can place concave lens next to the convex lens and study the ray paths. Instead of laser, we can use sunlight to study refraction of light with different lenses. I use a small beam of sunlight coming through a window in a dark room. Tilting the graph paper to align itself with the angle of incident rays renders a very beautiful pattern. All rays converge at a focal point. Here is how I calculated focal length of a convex lens from the formula when only radius of curvature is known. We will draw two circles of 5 cm radius with a slight overlap. The shape where overlap occurs is our convex lens profile. I used a laser cutting machine to cut 2 mm thick acrylic sheet. We can use lens maker equation to find out focal length of this lens. R1 is the radius of circle on the left side, while R2 is the radius of circle on the right side. For incident rays coming from left to right, value of R1 will be positive and that of R2 negative. Since both values are same, we can rewrite the equation. In the case of acrylic, focal length is same as radius of curvature. Can you find out focal length of this convex lens which has different radius of curvatures? Will it be same on each side? Do give it a try. Calculating focal length in different mediums is easy. Here is what you need to do. We'll use relative refractive index of acrylic in air as well as water. Rearranging the equation yields interesting results. Focal length of acrylic lens in water is almost 3.5 times its focal length in air. Our findings are nearer to the calculated value. This difference can be attributed to the casual homely setup, not very smooth surface of the lens and reading errors. If you don't have a laser, you can use a slit and normal phone flashlight to view the ray path. I tried it, but the results were not very promising. If you want these lenses or any specific LU for that matter, do write to me. We'll be happy to help. Sharing some tinkering moments during this activity. I used Inkscape software to build various profiles. Thank you.